leader, the top of the food chain, the big dog, the athletic leader, major, and the boss, please.
You should go see stock.
I need some crucial information. I need crucial information.
Who are you?
Well, that's not important. Girls or boys, who's better? Who's better?
What?
The hockey. You're not it. Are you him? Are you the top? Are you the leader?
I am the athletic director.
Oh, okay, perfect. So who's better? Is it the boys, the girls, the hockey? Which is the best?
Huh. I don't know if I can answer that. I have to be politically correct, so... everyone is really great.
Clearly you're not who I'm looking for. There's gotta be somebody else. Who is your leader?
Well, there is someone who's been here longer than anyone else.
I know where to go. I know where to go. Can I speak to her? Can I talk to her?
She's a very busy lady. Let me check her schedule though. Wait, 12:45. Free Britney. Sure, you did that. I think I can squeeze you in.
I mean, hold on.
Bless this most nutritious meal of cup of ramen, sold by the Jaeger on sale. Amen! So the games begin.
No one's supposed to be here, right?
I don't think so.
Thank you.
Open up! I need to take you to the office!
No, I got this one. It's Santa!
I'm Jewish!
Of a white Christmas, just like the ones I used to know.
I was young Zeke in that one. Who are you guys again?
I'm just here to get some photos for the Elville Performing Arts Instagram.
So you came to the right place. I'm Colin Critchley. I was on Netflix, Manifest. It's Kylie Jenner's favorite show, and she's a billionaire. I was on Broadway, Nickelodeon, Disney. It's the list, the list goes on and on, on and on and on and on. But yeah, so this is my first Winterfest audition. I've never done a school play before. I'm kind of more into professional stuff, you know, seasoned professional here. But yeah, I'm looking forward to working with the F-listers, the common people. But, you know, it's like a charity thing for me. I like to get in the zone in Hollywood. It's something De Niro talked to me a lot about.
You talking to me? You talking to me? You talking to me? Gabagoo? Still got it.
It's awesome because I really look as white as a ghost. Stop with this. Stop! Stop! On Critchley, it's a pleasure to meet you. Colin! What are you doing?
Where are the tears, Colin? Where are the tears?
Who are you? Who are you? You're Colin Critchley, that's right. You know, I used to go to the trailers and they'd have the makeup artist there, but ever since I stopped professional acting. I learned to do the makeup myself. I'll tell you what the problem is. I'll tell you exactly what the problem is. See, you don't listen. There are plenty of people who want to offer you help.
What's going on? I think he's presenting a Winterfest monologue. This is a math class.
It's method acting, fella.
These rookies don't know what it's like on Broadway, I'll tell you.
The biggest thing that they taught me on set is that a good meal is the key to having a good scene. What I learned is that you need a lot of protein. All these basketball kids, football kids, they think their sport is tough. Do you think they can cry on command? That takes real strength, and you need real protein. It's a light lunch today. They're gonna be stoked to see me, trust me. I'm basically a celeb around here.
Is there a sign-up sheet, or?
Hi, are you here for Winterfest?
Yes, I am.
Okay, who are you? Can you just put your name and...
Who am I? I'm an A-lister. Colin Critchley, Netflix, Disney, Broadway, Young Zeke, living under a rock.
Do you want to just sign in and put your...
I keep my own pen on me for signatures. The fans love the signature, so I'm telling you. You know, save that someday, sell it, and buy yourself something nice. Is there a VIP section?
All audition rooms are down the hallway down there.
No, there's not. Oh, okay. Hey.
I've never seen that guy in my life.
Colin, you're back, you're him, dude, you're him.
Who's my biggest competition? Ronnie. He was good in the Adams family, but not good enough.
Colin f***ing Critchley, don't let Roddy get you. Don't let Roddy get you.
Hey, Colin, we're ready for you in the audition room.
Sounds good.
Awesome.
It's go time.
Hey, how'd it go?
How'd it go? What did she think? Phenomenal.
Can we just get your email so we can get in touch with you if you do get cast? Just in case. Like...
Blue check.
Yep.
All requests go through my agent and manager. You can find me on IMDb though.
You know, sometimes I get so lost looking at myself in the mirror that I forget who I am. So for me at least, in the morning I like to do some daily affirmations to just say, you know, just water on the face, just a little, who are you? And then boom, I'm back. I'm Colin Critchley, right?
I'm Quinn Thierfelder.
And I'm Annie Katz. And this
is Weekend Update.
This is Weekend Update. Quinn Thierfelder and Annie Katz.
In breaking news, the Omicron variant is spreading quickly, and reports suggest it may be vaccine resistant. But that name sounds totally fake, so we don't really care.
In all seriousness, the naming of severe COVID variants follows the Greek alphabet. Thus far has been Alpha, Beta, Delta, and Omicron. However, reports suggest that next on this is Kappa Kappa Gamma, who we hear is a total ditz, but loves to party.
In other news, Mr. Wilder's camera has finally been returned. While the thief remains unknown, we can cross Jake Gyllenhaal from the list of suspects, since we know he never gives back other people's stuff.
At the end of fall term, public safety installed temporary supports in Mem Hall, claiming they were worried the building would collapse at any minute and kill everyone inside. The students taking their Calc BC final in the Healy room at the time issued a plea. Quote, I hope it does, end quote.
Honors chemistry students have been overwhelmed this year with their large amount of homework. Even more damaging is that they are exclusively known as the Honors Chem students.
Students recently had the opportunity to attend a Zoom conference on restorative justice. Now, while we still don't know what that is, we appreciate the designated nap time nonetheless.
In late November, the senior girls launched a Facebook page to post their prom dresses and prevent heinous copycatting. SNL would like to formally remind the senior class that prom is in fact in May. Sit the f*** down. Now, dear viewers, we cannot help but feel the holiday cheer upon us. In addition to being professional acquaintances and co-hosts, Quinn and I are also close friends. However, evidently not close enough, judging by the fact that I forgot to get her a Christmas present. Instead, I have created jokes for Quinn to read for this segment of Weekend Update.
Inspired by Michael Che and Colin Jost, we have prepared a joke swap. I have a few jokes for Annie to read that she has never seen, and Annie has a few for me. This is the first and only take of this scene. Annie, why don't you go first? I'll put your joke in the chat.
I turned 18 this past October, and I decided as a rite of passage to join Tinder. It's great to recognize so many friendly faces on the app, although I will say that I was shocked by the sheer quantity of 19-year-old sophomores.
During the recent major assignments week, many teachers went on strike, protesting overwhelming crowds during consultation. Since the protest failure, my email has been inundated with hate messages, with my teachers begging me to please leave their classroom and go to the bathhouse and get a life because I'm sad and annoying.
Last week, Raymond won the house dodgeball competition and one 15-year-old boy freshman single-handedly defeated five senior and postgraduate adult men from Upper. That is the entire joke that Quinn has written.
I am fake blonde. That is the entire joke Annie has written.
A large part of my campaign focused on community building, and thus I have helped the administration build community time into our daily schedules, including Tuesday advisory meetings, big red discussion groups, and SMeeting. I'm sorry.
A new club dedicated to cataloging the world's free market, the International Business Students, recently held their first meeting. I was surprised to find the club members discussing economics, as my expectations for the IBS club were slightly different.
Thank you, Quinn, so much for those jokes. Maybe next year we'll just go for something simpler, like a mug. But that's all for us, folks. Stay safe, wear a mask, enjoy your break, hug your seniors, They'll need it. And remember, turkey term is only a few more days.
We're Weekend Update. Happy holidays and good night.
Hi, I'm Jeff Dursel-Finley, and I am one of the enthusiastic college counselors here at Lawrenceville. Students, we hope you have all had a meaningful time with your families over Thanksgiving break, and that you are enjoying this time with your friends on campus before we depart for the winter. In the spirit of Thanksgiving wishes and holiday cheer, the College Counseling Office wants to say thank you. First, to our seniors, thank you for the dedication that you all have shown in your college applications thus far.
Your application is due in 12 days, and the only activity you filled out on the Common application is online shopping?
Okay,
are you kidding me?
The Aritzia Super Puff jacket is half off today, HBB. This is important.
Are you kidding me?
You all have been realistic and thoughtful about where you plan on applying.
So you're telling me that the only school you're applying to is Harvard?
You have been humble and aware about the complexities of college admission.
No, there's a safety, see? Yale's on the list.
And above all, you have been committed to creating the best applications that you possibly can.
No. 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 No! This is crazy. Are you?
What's wrong with it? I don't get it.
Are you really trying to tell me that you cured cancer?
HBB, it says I am a cancer.
To our juniors and sophomores, thank you for all the excitement you have shown in beginning your college process.
No, I'm not going to review your college essay yet. Why not? Because it's not due for another year.
Thank you for your commitment and your intelligence around standardized testing.
Thank you, Jimmy, for coming in and talking to me about your standardized testing. I really appreciate that. And as you can see, you scored a 20 on your test.
Oh, on the ACT?
No, on the SAT.
Oh.
Jimmy, you realize you get 400 points for writing your name. Do you even know how to write your name?
Yeah, of course I do.
And to our second formers, thank you for respecting the fact that the College Counseling Office is a special place reserved for the upperclassmen amidst their application preparation.
Hey you, freshman! What are you doing in here? Do you have ID? Are you a fifth former? Are you a fourth former? Who's sneaking in? You're not even in the third form yet! Get out of here, freshman!
So, on behalf of the College Counseling Office, thank you.
What's the biggest challenge you've faced?
Well, I mean, the bathhouse was out of Caprese's today, and that, like, really did me in. I just...
Thank you.
Better luck next time.
And thank you.
Get these donuts now, huh?
From the college counseling family to yours, happy holidays from all of us. Thanks.
Hey, excuse me, can you guys answer some questions for my honors stats project?
Yeah, sure.
On a scale of 2 to 6.713, how many majors have you broken on campus?
That's a really good question.
Hey, Emily, what's up? Ooh.
Yogurt?
How's it?
That's pretty good.
Do you mind if I have a little taste, maybe? It's in my stats project.
Hey, can I ask you a couple questions for my honors stats project?
Yeah, of course.
So, you know how everyone has a phone number, right?
Mm-hmm.
And you know there's 9 digits?
Yeah.
Do you happen to know those 9 digits? It's for the project.
It's 609.
Hey guys, my name's Megan, and welcome to the library. We have been decorating all week to help you get in the holiday spirit, so come on in. We have puzzles, wrapping papers, and all sorts to get you laughing, ho ho ho. And now it's time for the main attraction. For the first time in the school's history, we have our very own Santa Claus.
What? You wanna be happy, kid?
A little Christmas souvenir.
Hey, Santa, how's it shaking in the North Pole?
I don't get paid enough for this.
come out to the library for a fun time. I'm done. Are you for real?
What do you mean?
I don't know, I just feel like maybe I made you up.
I walked to the door with you. The air was cold, but something about it felt like home somehow. And I left my scarf there at your sister's house, and you still got it in your drawer even now.
Why didn't you just pick it up? Huh? Like, I don't remember that happening. Do you expect me to fall into something I don't remember happening?
I don't know any of those people. They're all strangers. I left my friends for this.
What are you talking? Of course you're making this about you. It's always about you. I don't even remember that happening. The spatula, when did that happen?
You treated me differently.
What do you mean I treated you?
You didn't talk to me.
Well, I was catching up with my friends, okay?
Well, maybe you should get better friends.
Oh my, you are being so selfish right now.
I'm being selfish.
Yes, no. I'm done.
Turkey Time is filled with holiday spirit and people.
What are you thankful for?
Coffee. I wouldn't be here without it. Also, poems. Those are good too, I guess.
Well. This book, it's a dictionary, English to Spanish. I got it when I was 4 years old and I never leave it up.
I am thankful for triangles.
I'm thankful for fruit flies.
Someone said I was a better teacher than John Green.
Wow, how inspirational. So much thankfulness. We heard what the teachers are thankful for, but what about the students?
Google Translate.
Phonemath.
Wikipedia.
That's enough. Wow. There's so much to be thankful for on the Lawrenceville campus. Are we done?
Yo, yo, Claire! You excited for this weekend?
Oh, yeah. I've been training for Lawrenceville Day all summer.
Tonight, we eat to prepare ourselves for the biggest day of our lives. Here at the Hill School, we don't care about any other sporting event. Super Bowl, World Cup, NBA Finals, what's that? SNLville Day. That's tomorrow. Tomorrow we mark the biggest day in history. We restore the honor of the Hill School. We will make the Hill School a semi-decent school. Now let's go tomorrow and wash that shirt.
Let's go! Let's go!
So, after a hard-fought battle and a hard day,
for you.
We lost. to Lawrenceville, Elville Day. You know, this is just the beginning, but next year we'll be back to win it.
Doubt that.
What?
No, you didn't go.
So today I'm giving this to the Lawrenceville school president.
Washing my shirt.